Okay, this is a test video. Test video. Okay, first of all, this is not about Raven. This is not about Katya. And definitely, this is not about Sandra. Although, I'll give it to you. That video would have had the same name. Hello, and welcome to Sassy Science. Today, we're going to talk about queens who were robbed. Robbed. So what's going on in the city of the Lord? Well, prepare to be amazed, a little bit pissed, outraged. But mainly amazed of this wonderful woman who got, how to say it? Robbed. Because of a woman. So, I've decided to do a series of videos about this. And who better to start than someone that really hits home? I remember when I was 15, my physics teacher told me about this case and it broke this poor queen's heart. For real. So, without further ado, let me introduce you to the one and only marvelous, genius, and robbed, Lise Meitner. Lise Meitner was born in Vienna in 1878 to a well-off Jewish family. Since she was very young, she developed a huge interest in research. And thanks to her very supportive parents, she managed to get private education. You go, supportive parents! Yo! After the longest fight and a huge lot of studying, I want to say huge, I mean she compressed 8 years into two. And I thought I was going to die just because I had a couple extra subjects on my last semester. She managed to get into university, and at 23, she got her PhD, being the second woman in her university to do so. Come through! After that, she moved to Berlin, where she met with Max Planck, you know, one of the fathers of quantum mechanics, and he actually accepted her. He hadn't accepted any girl in her lectures before. What the fuck, Planck? But she managed to, and actually 1 year later, she was working as his assistant. At that time, she started working with Aaaaand, and together they discovered several isotopes and even a new element. A new element. Come through! At 39, she became the first woman in Germany to hold a position as a full professor in physics, being praised by Albert Einstein as the German Marie Curie. I mean, now that she needs a man to validate her, but it's Albert fucking Einstein we're talking about. Okay, here's the first gag of the season. The first what the fuck moment. The first what? In 1922, she discovers the cause why certain atoms and their radiation emit electrons with a signature energy. Today, that's called the Auger effect, in honor of the French scientist Pierre Auger, who discovered that 1 year later. 1 year later. Bitch, what? How? Where? Who? Excuse me. Robbed. She was robbed. Okay, I mean, the results were split into different publications and that she actually buried a lot of particle physics, but it was there. Give credit where it's due, bruh. Give credit where it's due. I mean, there's almost been 100 years to right that wrong. Anytime. Anyway, the actual gag of the season, the face crack of the century,
the turning point,
is yet to come, because we ain't done yet. She convinces Hahn in 1934 to study the atom nucleus. Together they bombard uranium with neutrons, and girl, they found more radioactive species than dead drops in Ellipsing for Your Life. Okay, no, that pun was weak. I can do better. Hahn's job was to identify each and every one of the species, while Meitner's job was to explain the radioactive processes that were taking place in there. In the middle of all of this, as if it weren't enough, we encountered an even bigger problem. Hitler. Yes. Hitler. Adolf Hitler? You know him? Yeah, that's right. Even though she had converted to literalism, she still was considered non-Aryan. And then for when the restrictions tightened, she was pretty much forced to flee the country. And girl, the fierceness of it all. She fled to Sweden, crossing the Dutch border with, according to her, 10 marks on her purse and a small baggage of summer clothes. She was 59 at the time. How fierce is that? I mean, I have nothing but praise for that woman. I mean, she do got nerve. She do got nerve. And not only that, but she continued to help Hand with their work through letters they sent each other regularly. A few months after she had fled, Hahn and his assistant, Fritz Strassmann, found out that the elements obtained after bombarding uranium with neutrons were actually lighter than uranium and not heavier, which was predicted. And he literally wrote to her, saying, maybe you can come with some sort of fantastical explanation. Literally within days, she and her nephew had come with a model that explained nuclear fission. However, trust this bitch, this is the moment where you praise yourself. He did not list Meitner as a co-author when he published the results. Squeeze me. Rob. She understood it as a political move, taking into account that it was Germany in 1938. It kind of makes sense. But the fact that he convinced himself over the years that he had done that discovery on his own without the help of Meitner at all tells a different story. In 1944, the Nobel Prize is awarded to Hahn. Not listing Strassmann, who was his assistant, and not listing Meitner, who had been her equal partner for 30 years in the lab and had made the theoretical model for all of that. Bitch. No, that's just wrong. Bitch, who raised you? Also, shame on him, but like shame on all that Nobel comedy. Cause that kind of stuff people know. I mean, it's not something like, no. You know, like when that happens, you know, and you can reclaim it, and no one did, and it's just sad and infuriating. Catch me outside, how about that? So I can kind of understand how you feel right now. Angry, raged, with a huge will to smack a certain German scientist in the face. At least you can get some peace of mind knowing that even though he got the Nobel Prize all for his selfish hands, she got something he never did. And you can find it right now.
Are you ready?
Alright, so pause this video for a moment and go look for a periodic table. Oh, I was actually waiting for you to actually pause and, you know, go look for a periodic table. Go! Okay, now that you've found it, look for element 109. See the name? It's Meitnerium! In 1982, a German research group found it, and 15 years later it was named Meitnerium in honor of Lise Meitner. I guess, I hope, I wish, in an attempt to do some political justice about this. Anyway, at least, I hope that has given you some peace of mind. And that's all. I hope you've liked it. If you've liked it, please give it a thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe, everything that you want. If you don't subscribe, you know the homeopaths will win. Bye!